out of hatred and envy, murdered his brother Abel. His blood was spilled on the ground. And the writer of Hebrews says that Abel's blood cried out from the ground for justice. Abel's blood speaks. But the writer goes on to say that the blood of Jesus speaks, but the blood of Christ cries out and speaks better things than the blood of Abel.
Amen.
The blood of Abel demanded justice, but the blood of Christ speaks mercy and grace and forgiveness.
Amen.
At the same time, satisfying the righteous requirements of God, all the while conveying mercy and grace to the offenders, you and I. The blood of Christ speaks better things than the blood of Abel. Today, Lord, we've come into this room to revel in the promise that is provided to us by the blood of Christ. As people under a new covenant, a covenant that's been purchased, signed, sealed, and delivered by your lifeblood, the promise of hope and healing and restoration. The prophet Isaiah said that when the Messiah would come, he would be a man of sorrows, acquainted with grief, who would carry our sorrows, bear our griefs, and that by his stripes we would be healed. Your sacrifice, your shed blood, paid for our sin, paid for the mending of our broken hearts, paid for the sickness in our body. And I pray today, Lord, that the promises that are available to us through your work at the cross would be manifested in this room today, that we would see your work visibly, tangibly in our lives. We would sense the power of Christ resident in our lives, in this room, in our families today, because of the victory that belongs to your church through the cross of Christ. We celebrate you today, Lord Jesus. And we ask that all that belongs to your people would be ours. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 God bless you as you're seated today. Thank you so much.